were two particulars nevertheless, which I thought and still think might be fairly stated as characteristic of the intonation as well as adapted to convey some idea of its unearthly peculiarity. In the first place, the voice seems to reach our ears and at least mine from a vast distance, from some cavern in the earth. Comprehended as the gelatinous and gluttonous matters impress the sense of touch. I've spoken both of sound and of voice. I mean to say that the sound was one of distinct, of even wonderfully, thrillingly distinct syllabification. Mr. Valdemar spoke, obviously, in reply to the question. I have